Right, YouTube. I'm back home actually. I did not feel comfortable filming, so I'm gonna show y'all recommended some of my best bench press videos. I'm gonna probably show y'all a few scenes. This video right here was before I really understood copyright on videos and stuff like that. That's my best video, Rapid Time Fitness. That right there, just type that in. And some of my best bench press video was like middle of the video. It was not a video about bench pressing. It was a video about me going to the movie with my girlfriend and we were playing copyright music. So I titled it that, trying to get some views and whatever. But yeah, you watch that video. A matter of fact, I'm gonna show y'all some of the bench press scenes from that video. Some of my warm-ups. Heavy warm-ups, right? So I got that video right there, how to bench press, teaching you how to bench press. Type in rep and time fitness, how to bench press. Never mind, don't look at the gains. Only listen to people. Let me see, where's a good bench press video? Rules for beginners in the gym. That right there, that's new. 10 things to leave. That's not. Where's my video? I had the heaviest dumbbells. Gym fails. That right there, y'all see, that's the video I'll be always showing y'all. Let me see, 10 reasons why. I don't remember what I was talking about. Good form, bad form. I was teaching you. See, I be teaching a bunch of stuff, man. I gotta get back in my. That's what it used to be called, movie night. No, that's a playlist. Play that playlist. You talk too much. Not you. You can read. I was talking about that. The police. I don't remember what I was talking about. Sharks, fitness. Fool. Where's the deadlift? Summer shredding. Something about pre-workout. There's something in the water. I think I was calling people stupid. That's who is it? Bench press. No way home. Where's that video? I got so many bench press videos, man. Chest workout. Car problem. That wasn't my car problem. It was somebody else's car. That's my car, but I'm just saying, like, you know, wake up. Part-time job. I do not have a part-time job at Hardee's, by the way. That was like kind of. It was like an accidental clickbait. You know how YouTube picks your whatchamacallit, your thumbnail. But yeah, let's go look at some of my other bench presses. All right, y'all. This is 18 minutes into that same video I just showed y'all, and I'm gonna have to mute it because there's a lot of copyright music in there. There was copyright music all the way through the first video. The video ain't about me lifting. This is 275. I just put it in there for extra. And yeah, the video was about us going to the movies and everything else. So I'm gonna show y'all 275. I think I was a little heavier than I am now. Yeah, so let's go. Let's go ahead. Lift this weight. Yeah, boy. So you gotta have that serious face. People be like, what you mean by serious and focused? If you're playing under this weight, I think I was 175 or give or take at the time. I'm like 160 right now. Yeah, I gain and lose weight. You know what I'm saying? I used to be big in the bulking and cutting. Like, see how easy that is? This is part of my warm up. Right now, that'd be heavy for me to do one. You know, I'm not struggling. I was basically testing the waters because I was moving up. A warm up, and then you put on more weight. Watch, I'm gonna put on some more weight. Take the camera. So this is 315. These are three plates on each side. You know, a lot of people, you only show one side. I'm gonna have three plates on this side and then nothing on that side. You're crazy. So let's see how 315 went up. As you see, there's nobody behind me. No spotter. So this is easy weight to me. Now, right now, can I do 315? Maybe. Would I have a spotter behind me? Yeah. Would I be able to perform the lift? I don't know. Maybe I fail. That's why I would have a spotter behind me. I'm trying to teach you how to things. Why you don't lift without a spotter? Because I know my limits. I know what I should and shouldn't be doing. I am not a beginner. Do not put me in the same category if you are a beginner. My beard was shorter back then, but it was a lot neater than it is nowadays. You know what I'm saying? This is about 3 years ago. Let me see. Let me go and lift the lift first so y'all show y'all what it looked like. go to my how-to bench videos, and I'll teach you step by step what I'm doing. You do not just lay on the bench and do it. 315, little bit of a struggle, not too hard, not too crazy, not a max. So this video was shot 3 years ago, January 22nd, 2019, and it only got 199 views. Really? This was one of my best videos. I think I just had the most good stuff at the end. I put I don't know if that's 5 or 10 pounds on each side. I don't remember. All I know is my max back then was I don't know if I was doing 365 then or not. Cause I think I was only 175. I think I did the lowest I did at 365 was body weight. The lowest I did 365 pounds on the bench press. My body weight was probably 180. So I don't think I was doing 365 then. And this is after coming back too, cause a lot of people did I do this lift or did I fail? Of course I didn't fail. I have a spotter. Okay, I'm getting ready. You have to get ready. That's why right now you cannot be talking with this weight. If this weight was to fall on my neck, what you think would happen to me if this weight was to fall on my neck? Huh? Wouldn't be able to breathe. What happened if you can't breathe? You finished that. What happened? Exactly. You cannot. Oh, those are fives. Okay. So this is 315 plus 5 plus 5. That's 10. You know what I'm saying? It's 5 on this side, 5 on that side, of course. So that's 315 plus 10. This is 325 pounds. Oh, I bailed out. I'm teaching y'all something right here. So what I'm saying was that wasn't working for me. I got the captions on. That was not working for me. So I dropped down to 75. No, I dropped down to 275. The captions are messed up. So I dropped back down from 325 to 275. So I took 50 pounds off to do some rep work. That was warm-up weight. Now I was repping weight. See what I'm saying? That's why they call me repping. But I'm trying to teach you something. Know your limits. Know your limits so you can know where to go from there, whether up or down. Always tell beginners, do not go in the gym lifting as heavy as you possibly can just because you see somebody else doing a high amount of weight. That does not do. I weighed 175 in this. If you're 175, that does not mean that you can do this weight. This is after years of lifting. This is after years of know-how. I hope I'm getting hurt right now, bro. Like, for real. Like, okay. Let me look what's down there. Lottery. What is down there? Go down, not up. Okay. Okay, how I'm going live. Cardi B, Tasha K. Cardi B and Tasha K case. That was clickbait. I just put that out there. My morning workout, which I didn't film, just like this one. But let's see what I did with this 275. See what I did with this 275. How many reps? Okay, I'm gonna get 5 reps. To say in the captions, 5 reps of 275, which is 100 pounds over my body weight. That's a lot of things that a lot of people don't understand. Pound for pound, a lot of guys. Like NFL Combine, those guys, wow, my hair must have been greasy because the light is shining. I had just cut my own hair too, so, you know what I'm saying, if it had looked messed up. I used to have braids. If you see my before pictures, I used to have braids and stuff. And so I look like I got plugs out of my hair. I got wave videos that shows that's not how my hair looks. It's all good. So you almost kissed the bar. Everybody's set up different. So let's see how I do with this. This is after benching threesome, so I'm kind of fatigued. One, see how easy they're going compared to the warm-up reps? That's 3, 4. Come on, you got to get 5 or 6. Come on, man. 5. Now, my record with 275 is like 10 reps, 11 reps, something like that. I don't know. But I was like 180. And plus, I was more consistent. That's what I be trying to tell people, like, consistency, being in the gym, out of the gym, blah, blah, blah. So, what am I doing? I don't know. Y'all have to watch the rest of this video yourselves. I'm not going to go through all that. Went down some. Oh, no, that's too. Yeah, I went down some. But like I said, I don't know what I'm going to do with these reps or whatever. But if you want to know exactly, This is one of my best bench press videos, even though it's not a bench press video. There's a lot of things explained in this video. By the way, remember, this is what the video is titled, but you have to type in Reppin' Time Fitness, the game featuring Nas, Street Riders. Don't just type in the game Street. That's a good song. You can listen to that. You can type in that or whatever. But the song is on here. The whole song. I really didn't know what I was doing back then. I was that crazy. I did not know nothing about YouTube at all back then. But this is 3 years ago when I started my channel. But if you type in Reppin' Time Fitness this, you will hear the song and you will see this. So you'll get the best of both worlds. Now, this video is actually dope. But if you, this, the lifting part starts at 18 minutes. Remember that. A matter of fact, I'm going to link it below. Matter of fact, what am I talking about? Look it up. Back then, I didn't know how to link. Do you know I was almost sponsored by a couple people back then when I first started? And they wanted me to go look at Reppin' Time Fitness previews of reviews or whatever. I reviewed a lot of different products back then. People used to send me stuff. I might get back into doing that. Like, you know what I'm saying? But one company was going to sponsor me. But I did a video about them and about some gloves or whatever. Not this video, but another video. And I wish Heartbanger was going to sponsor me. Wow, it took me a long time. Like, see, back then, I used to, like, really explain to you. Like, if you look at the video, all of this video has copyrighted music. I got to get the baby. Okay, Momo. But yeah, all this video is here. Get your bottle. Say, man, this video is from me 3 years ago. I looked a lot bigger back then. I was not as lean as I am now. That's the difference between bulking and cutting too. A lot of people who has the untrained eye is easily fooled by people who are big and husky and you think it's muscle. Bulking and cutting, when you take your shirt off, you can't hide the fat. Like right there, I don't look like I'm fat. I'm not really that fat. I'm big. I'm muscular and I'm strong. But if I took my shirt off then compared to if I take my shirt off now, oh, I'm cutting through that like butter. Oh, wow. I got to look at my old videos myself. You know what I'm saying? The company that was going to sponsor me ended up not sponsoring me because I didn't know how to put their link in my description or whatever. I might try to get back in contact with them. I didn't know. I know how to do it now, of course. It's 3 years ago. You know what I'm saying? My first day back to the gym. I'm here. I said I was not going to do no talking before I went in the gym because it kind of messed me up sometimes. But I have to do this one time. It is 2:21 in the morning. I'm going to do a review on these gloves. I'm going to show them to y'all in a minute. I'm not about that. You know what I'm saying? People want you to do what's hard. It's hard. Just do it. Tear your shoulder up. Ah! Trying to get the dang. But I'm going to show y'all something, man. This is dope. This is so dope. Watch this. Flip the camera around. Y'all might not understand what I mean, but there is nobody. There is no cars here. I own the gym. I think it's because my gym is under new ownership. It's not even going to be Goals no more. It's going to be something else. And I had to download the app and this and that. I had some trouble getting in, which is one of the main reasons why. Let me flip y'all back to me real quick, because a lot of people, I don't see your face. I'm going to click. One of the reasons why I have not been in the gym. This ain't the only reason. And I ain't blaming others for me not being in the gym, this and that and the third. It's only been in a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks at tops. I'll show you what the video is about real quick first, though. Here they go. I can feel the cardboard. I got so much unnecessary stuff in my bag. Bam. These are Heartbringer. Let me show y'all real good, though. But first, before I show y'all, these are gloves, all right? Put them on your hand. You lift weights with them. You know what I'm saying? The gym, I ain't hit the gym in a long time. So my plan is, and I'm trying to teach you how to do this the smart way. Put my car in park. Let me tell you how to do this the smart way, all right? If you're a beginner or somebody who has not been in the gym a long time, I don't really have to do this right now because it's only been a week and a half, 2 weeks. But I'm smart. I care about my body more than I care about showing off. I understand that this comes from longevity. You're not going to get this from one workout. You could go in there right now today and have the best workout of your life.
the best workout in your life is still just a little drop in the ocean of the sea of the things that you have to do to get these results. It's like this little light right here in the sunlight. It doesn't even out. You feel me? My durag is so high. Why is it always like that? Every time I do a video, my lips start getting chapped. I don't know. Everything to be out of place. You know what I'm saying? But what I'm trying to say is ease your way in. You know, if I could lift some heavy weight today, cool. My goal is not to lift as heavy as I possibly can. I want to do some good reps with some good weight and test out these gloves and have a successful first day back. I do not want to hurt myself on my first day back. Okay, I missed 2 weeks. Now, if I hurt myself, how long am I going to miss then? Then I'll be really starting over, if I can start back over.
Hey, y'all, these are called Heartbringers. No, they're Heartbringers. I always call them Heartbringers. I don't know, but these are the Pro Wrist Wrap Gloves. So this right here is a wrist wrap. It's strapped up, you know what I'm saying? It's actually long, hold on. Wrap that strap around your wrist. It helps protect your wrist. It's all about safety, man. Grip and all that stuff, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, easy breathe. These right here are probably the best gloves I've ever had. Look at the pattern. You know, these are probably the best gloves I've ever had. These are medium black. You do not want, I could fit large real good, but I like my gloves tight. I like to have that firm feel when I'm lifting. If I'm lifting heavy weights, anybody who knows what lifting feels like, we like everything to be pretty tight on us. We don't want our shoes to be loose, nothing to be loose. Your drawers being loose. Hold on, let me show you my face when I say this. I'm serious. You do not want nothing loose when you're lifting weights. You do not want your drawers creeping up and grabbing and twisting things, especially if you're like deadlifting or squatting. It sounds funny. You might be laughing right now, but you do not. I do not know how females feel, but I'm pretty sure women feel some way. But a dude, you go down to that squat and you... You know what I'm saying? Especially when you're lifting heavy weight. Okay, let's be serious about it. When you're lifting heavy weight, that's another reason why a lot of people don't understand. And I'm not about to talk about this in this video because I talk about this every video, but I'm going to say it briefly. A lot of people be wondering why I do not like people all on me when I lift weights. Because I lift. Now, if you do not lift real weight, if you lift some play around weight or whatever's real to you, might not be real to me and blah, 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 you don't know what I mean. I don't expect you to understand. Now, I can't always lift that. There's time, it comes and goes. I explain all the times, the ins and outs, the ups and downs, mass moves mass, calories in, calories out, this and that, and the third, energy, consistency, how long you missed the gym. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of reasons your strength will go up and down. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people, if you can lift 400 pounds. Well, that wasn't 400 pounds. It's close. But if you can lift 400 pounds, you should always be able to lift 400 pounds. You just go up and up and up and up and up. If that was the case, you would have way more 1,000-pound bench pressers in this world. How many people can lift 1,000 pounds on a bench press? I think Julius Maddox did like 800. There's people that can do like 800, 700, stuff like that. Those are the world class, and of course they're on needles in the butt. Ah, you know what I'm talking about, right? I'm natural, so you know what I'm saying? I ain't scared to talk about people like that at the end of the day. Truth is the truth, whatever, man. A lot of people are like, man, because they're going to, dog. If you want to learn from somebody who can teach you how to get here naturally, who can actually help you reach your goals, you have reached the right channel. But I'm going to go in there before somebody start pulling up. People are like, why are you looking over your shoulders? Because I am, yes, I'm scared. I'm not scared of robbers. I'm not scared of anybody coming and doing anything to me because, hey, I'm scared of people stopping my workout. This is my first workout back. I cannot. Like, people do not understand what I be meaning. Like, if you're, before I go, this is the last thing I'm going to say. Before I go, if whatever your goal is, right, it could be fitness or whatever else. If you're okay with failing, yes, fails will happen, and it doesn't mean the end of the world. I'm not saying that before I say this because somebody will put words in my mouth. But if you're okay with not reaching your goals,
then those weren't your real goals in the first place. You weren't really serious in the first place. There's better ways to say it, but this all off the top of my head. But hey, I'm telling you. Why does it even matter? Because that was my goal. Why does it matter? That's why people ain't getting nowhere. Because y'all, why does it matter? You ain't just asked me that, did you, dog? Why does it matter? Oh, it don't even matter. It shouldn't matter. Hey, maybe this ain't your thing. Maybe it don't matter to you. I guarantee you, I'm hoping that something matters to you. Okay, now imagine that thing and it matters to you. Now imagine failing at it. Yes, there's other important things, but this is my thing. I mean, people don't, that's why I don't talk, because people don't understand anyways. Only thing they'll do is try to prolong the conversation. You do your set. Try to, you know, in between sets is important. You ain't gonna do a set, then do a set, then do a set, then do a set. People that don't lift weights, if you do a bunch of cardio, this is not cardio. You're not gonna do a heavy set and then 2 seconds later do another heavy set. No, it's gonna take a minute or two. Especially if you're doing like powerlifting style workout. I mean, if you're going close to your max, which some people argue this and some people argue you shouldn't be doing that. Shouldn't be doing what? If that was my goal, if my goal was to be a powerlifter, ain't no way you gonna tell me I shouldn't be doing it. There's no way. I don't understand why you got so much time to tell somebody that anyways. I mean, you cutting it to your... I'm cutting it to my own self. Let me go work out real quick. Because ain't nobody listening. I'm gonna show you. My
clothes. All right, so when you go in the gym, make sure you know what I'm saying, do what you gotta do. There's nobody in here. I'm in here by myself, so... You know, the best thing about it, nobody can conversate with me. You know, I'm in a locker room, and people, man, I got the wrong size gloves, I feel like. They're kind of tight. You know, like I said, these are mediums. I should have probably got the large, but they might be all right after I break them in, you know what I'm saying? You know, it just feels a little eh. But you want it to be a little snug, you know? If it's too loose, then, you know, it's baggy. You know, baggy gloves. But look at this. I love when the gym is dark over there on the other side. That means nobody's in there. Of course, it'd be a little bit darker if I wasn't even there. The lights that wired me or came on. That ab machine right there, that's trash. A lot of machines are good. I'm a machine guy, too. I like free weights, but that is
trash. All right, y'all. The gloves did their job. They did a pretty good job. They held up real good. The only problem was the picking of the size. And I should have got a large. During the workout, they was kind of tight, and I'm feeling like maybe they, you know, when they get broken in and this and that and the third. But after the workout, pulling these things off, no, nothing's wrong with the brand. This is my favorite brand. I just picked the wrong size. That was my fault. You know what I'm saying? This is a great brand of glove. The grip is great. The feel, everything is perfect. I've been lifting for 8 years. I'm not a beginner. I am an experienced, advanced lifter. I am a natural lifter. A lot of people, such and such, you advanced lifter, but such and such, man, don't that mother. I can't talk, I can't breathe when I'm not explaining none of you. I'm natural, stupid. You're not stupid, but man, because I'll be getting tired of people, man. Y'all don't understand what I go through. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. You're not. I ain't talking to everybody when I say it, but don't apply, let it fly. Nah, man, because, man, people call me stupid all the time, man. I'm talking to the people that be talking to me like that or trying to. I won't let nobody talk to me like that. But it gets on my nerves, man. I'm going through a slump. But I'll be back. I'm probably going to take a break, man. I'm getting tired. No, it's not because of YouTube. I am probably going to take a break on YouTube, but it's just... I don't know. I think I'm doing too much. It's your first day back. I explained it when I got the words for it. I ain't got the words for it right now, man. Anybody that does a lot probably know exactly what I... You get overwhelmed. I don't expect everybody to understand. Ugh. Nah, man. Nah.